students, today we will discuss about the klystron characteristics. That is, we will discuss about the klystron mode characteristics, plus klystron mode characteristics. And here you can see the bench set here, and this is the first part is the klystron power supply, and the next this will give the bias voltage to this reflex klystron. And this is the detector mount, and the reflex klystron is fixed on this detector mount. And there is a fan. That fan is used to cool the reflex klystron, or it is used to avoid the heat produced during its operation. And after the reflex klystron, there is an isolator, and which will pass the flow of microwaves only in one direction. That means it will isolate the input from the output. And the next is frequency meter, which is used to measure the frequency produced by this reflex klystron. And the next is the variable attenuator, and this will provide attenuation, and its plunger can be moved up or down in order to provide minimum attenuation. We are moving this plunger upwards so that it will be open, so that it will not produce any attenuation for the frequencies produced here. And next is the slotted section, and that we have explained in the previous experiment. And next is the detector mount, and which is used to take output from this setup, and the output can be seen in the CRO, so that the output cable is connected here, and that will again connected to the channel 2 of the CRO. So this is the setup, and first we can go to this power supply, which is a plus klystron power supply. You can see here. And we have to take precaution in doing this experiment, and before switching on the power supply, we have to take a look on this. See, there are different knobs. First one is the beam voltage knob, and which is used to vary the beam voltage. And there is another knob, that is repeller voltage knob, and which is used to vary the repeller voltage. And before doing experiment, you should ensure that this beam voltage knob is at minimum point and repeller voltage is at maximum point. That means that it should give repeller voltage of maximum value. That means actually it is a negative voltage value. Negative maximum means it is the minimum value. So it should be in full anti-clockwise position, and this beam voltage will be should be in full repeller voltage should be in full clockwise direction, and a beam voltage should be in full anti-clockwise direction. And there is a meter selector switch, and so that we can select a voltage, current, or repeller mode. So if we want to display the voltage, we have to put this knob into voltage direction like this, and if we want to measure the current, we have to put it in current so that it will display the current value. If we want to display the repeller voltage, then we have to put it in repeller mode. So that when we put it in this knob in repeller side, so that this will shows the repeller voltage, which is a negative value. And by varying this repeller knob like this in the anti-clockwise direction, we can vary the repeller voltage. Okay. Next is a modulation switch, and so that we can select different modulation schemes such as continuous wave, amplitude, frequency, or external. Yeah. In this reflex klystron mode characteristic, we are selecting the amplitude AM modulation. And if we put this knob in AM modulation, then in order to vary the amplitude and frequency of the amplitude modulated wave, we have to change these knobs. So before switching on the power supply, these all knobs, that is, these are the amplitude knobs for the amplitude modulation, and this is the amplitude knob for the frequency modulation, and this is the frequency knob for the amplitude modulation, and this is the frequency knob for the frequency modulation. So before doing the experiment, you should ensure that all these are at minimum position. That means it should be in the full anti-clockwise direction. And when we put it in the AM mode, in order to vary the frequency or amplitude, we have to change this and this. These knobs are not using. And if we want to check any external circuits, we have to put this knob into external mode, and we have to connect the circuit here. And this is the knob from where we are taking the supply from this klystron power supply. So it will go to this klystron. And so That's all about this microwave bench explanation. Here you should take care that before switch on this power supply, we have to switch on the fan, and also ensure that the frequency meter should be at a lowest position, and also this be at a minimum. That means it should provide a minimum attenuation, and also you have to arrange this anywhere here, this slotted section anywhere here, and you can see the output in the CRO. So let us start experimenting in the next video.